I'm Paul Nguyen from Blue Hour Photo Ventures, and I'm going to teach you how to use the Map View module in Sun Surveyor. The Map module is a great way to get an overhead visualization of the landscape you're in, or plan to be in, along with the relevant positions and predictions for the sun and moon. In order to see the maps, you need a data or Wi-Fi connection so the maps can load into Sun Surveyor. First, establish your location, either currently or a remote location of your choice. I explained the location tool in the overview video. You'll see a Google map of your location and an overlay of a compass, and the relevant sun and moon information that you've opted to see in the info panel selection. Just as with the 3D compass view, the green pin represents your selected position. If you've chosen your position by GPS, it's where you're standing now. You can fine-tune your position by dragging the map around if you'd like, and the green pin then settles on your newly chosen position. If you've turned the sun info panels on, the compass on the map view shows the current position of the sun, an arc representing the path of the sun through the sky on this particular day, and the path is marked with where the sun will be at every hour of the day. If you look at the sun, sunrise, and sunset panels, you'll see that each has a specific color, yellow, orange, or red, and these colors will correspond with the information shown in the compass itself. The yellow line points to the direction of the sun relative to you right now. The orange line points to the direction of where the sun rose this morning, and the red line points to where the sun will set this evening. You can choose to turn off the sunrise and set direction by clicking on their panel. Likewise, if you selected to see moon information, you'll see a similar color-coded representation of the moon's path throughout the day. You can rotate the map by placing two fingers on the screen and turning them clockwise or counterclockwise. You can tilt the map by placing two fingers on the screen and dragging them up. And at any time, you can reset the map to its default view by pressing on the little compass icon in the top left. The right side has a toolbar with useful map tools. The plus and minus buttons allow you to zoom in and out on the map while keeping your position exactly the same. The compass tool allows you to see which way you're facing on the map using the device's internal compass. Just make sure your compass is properly calibrated, which I explain in its own video. When the compass tool is red, the compass is activated and tracks your bearing in real time. Touching it again locks the compass at that bearing. You can always return the map to the default direction by touching the small compass in the top left. The Map Layers tool lets you choose what type of map you're seeing, whether it be the basic Google map with street and location names, the satellite map, a hybrid of the two, or a map that shows the terrain or relief. I'll choose satellite. The Tripod tool lets you fix the location of the compass to the map so that when you drag the map, the compass stays where it is, but a new target point appears in the middle of the map, and a green line appears connecting the two points. Up here, you see the measured distance and angle between the two points. The Bullseye tool locks the position of the target point, so now when I drag the map, the compass follows me where I go, but I still see the green line and the distance between my original point and my new location. The Tripod and Bullseye can be used together, so that now both points are locked as I drag the map around. If your location is in a place that's been documented by Google Street View, you'll see a little Street View icon pop out at the lower left. Touching this brings you into the Street View, which is a virtual 360-degree visualization of the world in that location, but here it comes complete with your sun and moon information. It's a little like using Live View for a remote location, but you have to navigate around the view by manually dragging it. But just like with Live View, you can choose to show or hide certain pieces of information using the info panel, and travel through time. The Street View is a fantastic tool for remotely planning a photo shoot. Street View can also be accessed from the main menu. Changing back to the regular map view is as easy as touching the small map icon in the bottom left.